So this is a question I hear over and over again online, on the Apple discussion groups. I get asked it. It's asked in other forums all over the place. Is why does system storage on my Mac take up so much space? If you go into About My Mac and then go to Storage and then go and look at the bar for system storage, sometimes it can look alarmingly big. Well, I'm going to tell you why you probably see it as looking really big, why it's probably not as big as you think, and how to find out what really is taking up the space. So first, looking here, notice what happens when you first go to Storage. You'll see that you get a kind of general, like used and not used. And then after a while, then it starts to divide it up into sections. And when it first does this, system storage looks huge. So in my case, it's almost 90 gigs. And a lot of people make the mistake of stopping here. They figure something's wrong and they, you know, go to investigate it or not investigate it or complain or whatever. But what they don't do is they don't wait, because it's still calculating. It's still going to try to figure some things out. And it takes a while. I'm showing you this in real time. So you can see now it's still not updating. It's still not updating. It still just shows you that it's 90 gigs in system storage and leaving you to guess what's wrong. I really think there should be a little message there saying still calculating or something like that. But if you wait long enough, eventually it will begin to divide things out. And what it's doing there is it's looking in the system and library folders and it's figuring out what's inside there. And if it finds something that belongs in another category, it will move it to that other category. But it takes a while. So if we wait long enough, we'll see it change. And there it just did. So you could see it took a big chunk and it put it into iCloud Drive. So iCloud is actually accounting for a lot of what was previously seen as being system. The thing is that in one of the library folders is an actual folder that contains the data for iCloud Drive files and other things. So it sees that as being part of the system folder. It reports that back. And then as it gets more information about what's in the system folder, it says, ah, I could break this out and put it in another category. Now, even though 50 gigs of system storage is now allocated to iCloud Drive, 40 gigs still seems too big, right? So you want to investigate. Now, unfortunately, if you go to Manage and you look, you're just going to be told the same thing, that there's a lot taken up by system storage. But you have complete control to be able to look in the folders on your Mac and figure out what's what. So why not do that? Now, I happen to know that system storage is going to be in both the system folder and the library folder. So the first place I want to look is at the computer level and look at the system folder and use Command I to get info and then see how big that is, and do the same thing with the library folder. And using that, I can account for half of system storage. But only half. So where is the other half? Well, there are two library folders. You see, there's a library folder for the system, but there's also a library folder for each user. So if I go into my user library folder, and you can get to there by going to the Go menu, and you won't see library there initially, but if you hold the Option key down on your keyboard, library appears, and you can go to the library folder. And looking in the library folder, I could see that it's huge, and also I could see that there is a folder in there that is that iCloud Drive data I saw before, but also other folders that are taking up lots of space as well. And I can look in those and get an idea of what's being used for. It's being used for cache files. It's being used to cache my iCloud photo library. So I have some of the photo images there. It's being used to cache files, being used to cache things for Safari. It all seems accounted for. And it's all being really well used because I have this space on my drive. So my Mac knows that it should use it to try to speed up my experience. If I was shorter on space, if I didn't have that much space on my drive, it wouldn't use so much. But since I have that space, it's using it very wisely to give me a better computing experience on my Mac. And that accounts for all of the system storage space. There's no mystery there. It's all accounted for and it all makes sense.